I am not really sure if I should title this video The Truth About Angela City. Maybe this topic is too hot. I can get my finger burned very easily from this story. But let's see as we start this story. I remember walking down this street for the first time in 1975. At that time, this street was full of young American GIs from the Clark Air Base, which was very close to Angela City. In the bars around here, you could find about 6,000 young, slim, beautiful girls from all over the Philippines. I am lucky. I still have this video footage of Angela City that I took only 1 week before the eruption of Mount Pinatubo volcano. I would like to share this video with you. It reminds us of the old Angela City, with these simple bars and beautiful girls. In these days, when the American GIs wear the costumes, who keep the bars and bar girls in business? I won't tell you what men do in the bar of Angela City, because it is not our business. But let's just say that they are not there to just drink beer. Yes, there was also sex shows. Studio One Bar was one of the famous place. Maybe you can still remember this. Also the Nipperhard Bar or the Bar For Your Eyes Only. I think I should remind you, in those days a cold beer in Angela City was only 10 pesos. A lady's drinks were only 25 pesos. A short time with a beautiful young woman was only 100 pesos. Oh yes, on every door to the heaven you could find the sign. Short time, only 3 hours. Actually, I was in Angela City on that day when the Mount Pinatubo volcano really blew up at 3 p.m. in the afternoon of Saturday, June 15, 1991. 1 week later, I went back to Angela City because I needed to see with my own eyes how it looks after the eruption. Nearly all of the roofs on the buildings and houses had collapsed under the weight of the falling ash. The American Air Force Base at Clark was badly damaged by the eruption of Mount Pinatubo. The American GIs left Angela City and the Philippines. No more Americans means no more business in the bars. Nearly all of the 6,000 girls left Angeles City. Some of them returned home to the province. But most of these bar girls went to Ermita, the red light district of Manila. At that time, I was very sure it was the end of the nightlife in Angeles City. I think in that time you could buy a bar for only one bottle whiskey. I remember only 3 out of 300 bars were still open. The Happy Hooker Bar, the Black Pearl Bar and the Welcome Inn Bar. If you think of sex in the Far East, you immediately think of Bangkok. Who knows what was going on in Ermita, Manila in 1992? More than 10,000 beautiful sexy girls worked in the bars in Ermita, the sinful district of Manila City. I still remember the names of some of these nightclubs. There was Lovebird Clubs, Trillen Club, Pit Stop, Pussycat Disco Pub, Superstar, New Bangkok Club, Blue Hawaii, Firehouse, Mascot and Australian Club. In that time was Manila with these many colorful lights like a magnet for these young provincial girls. If you said that most men only came to Manila for sex, yes, you would be right. Sex with a sweet, loving, cute Filipina was the dream for every man coming to Manila. Can you tell me what man could resist and say no to such beautiful, sexy woman? But yes, nothing is for free. Everything has a price, and for this love, a man need to pay. But most men didn't feel they're paying for sex. Most of them, they feel they give money as a gift to a girlfriend. But in 1993, the new mayor of Manila, Mr. Alfredo Lim, made the impossible come true. He dictated to shut down all bars, nightclubs, massage parlors in Manila. Many bar owners transferred then from Manila to Angeles City, and the shopless bar girls followed them. You could say that this shutting down the red light district in Ermita opens up the doors for a new start of life for Angeles City. From that time on, Angeles City started to growing fast as more and more tourists came and more hotels and bars was built in Angeles City.